age to come. What are the powers of the age to come? If you read Hebrews chapter 6 verse 4, for it says here, "For it is impossible in the case of those who have once been enlightened, who have tasted the heavenly gift and have shared in the Holy Spirit and have tasted the goodness of the word of God and the powers of the age to come." This is the only place in the whole Bible where you'll find the phrase "powers of the age to come." Now, what are the powers of the age to come? If you look at that word, it says powers and not power. It's in the plural, which means it's a multiple of powers. Multiple of power, not just one. In the year 2008, Brother Neville Johnson and I, we were invited to preach at a conference in the US in a state called Louisiana and in a city called Baton Rouge. On the first day that we arrived in Baton Rouge, I was waiting on God for the meeting, and I was visited by four angels. The four angels, the chief among them spoke and said, "We are the guardian angels, or the chief angels of the state of Louisiana." And then the angel said, "God wants you to speak at this conference on the powers of the age to come." You know, except this phrase being mentioned in the Bible, there's nothing more or more information is not found anywhere else about what are the powers of the age to come. So I then asked the angel, "Please teach me and explain to me what these powers of the age to come." And then the angel went on explaining to me. In explaining the gifts to me, he reminded of a vision that I saw a couple of days before. He said, "Do you remember this vision that you saw?" And the vision that I saw was, I saw myself and another prophet friend of mine, we were walking down the hallway of a certain school. I do not know which country it was, but we were walking down the hallway. And as we were walking down the hallway, I looked at all the classrooms on my right, and they were all empty. No students were found in the class. And I wondered what in the world happened to this school where all the students were. And we passed by several classrooms. All were empty. Then we came to one classroom, and there were three teachers, two male and a female. And the male who stood in the center was taller than the other person. And they were talking about something, and maybe about studies or school plans. And I noticed that the man in the center, his right hand was twisted and bent. And I understood that because of polio attack, his hand was twisted and bent very, very terribly. And we just stood there at the entrance of the classroom and just looked at him. And after some time, his teacher turned and looked at me. When he did, his hand was instantly healed. I did not pray for him. I did not touch him. I did not say, "Be healed." What happened was, he turned and looked at me, and that look healed him. And I was so excited, and I told this prophet friend, "Look, he was healed." So this friend said, "Come, let's go to the soccer field, because that's where all the students are gathered. We need to preach the gospel to them." And when we went to the soccer field, these teachers also came along with us. And when the student body saw the teacher with who had a withered hand, his hand is now straight and he was moving his hands, arms in a very wonderful manner, they were all shocked and to know what had happened to his arm. The teacher then testified to the whole student body what happened to them. And everybody was